Hi everyone, welcome to the webinar titled Machine Learning in Healthcare. My name is Shubham Goyal. I am a data wizard in the MachineX group at Nolders, playing with data in healthcare sector. Today we are going to discuss about a subtopic of machine learning in healthcare, that is how machine learning or ML is transforming medical treatment and diagnosis. So firstly about me, I am an artificial intelligence enthusiastic, interested in doing researches on different problems and a regular contributor to society through blogs and webinars in machine learning and artificial intelligence. So without wasting our time, let's move to the today's agenda. Firstly, we will have a look on healthcare at a glance. It means about healthcare sector, what is healthcare is and how it is beneficial for a country's economy and for the people of a country. Followed by why machine learning or AI is important in healthcare. And after that, we will see some use cases and how top companies and which are the top companies using ML in healthcare. After that, an interesting research which I had recently done in healthcare sector using machine learning. We will see the problem statement and the solution of that and how it is beneficial for the society. And at the end, we will see the conclusion of this webinar. So before jump to the main topic, I would like to talk a bit about our tribe MachineX. MachineX is a group of data wizard who love to play with data and create wonders out of it. It's a group of thinkers who loves to contribute to the development of artificial intelligence and machine learning. And hence you can see the things we are doing. We built a library called KSAI, which is an ML library, consists of various algorithms written in Scala. We regularly post blogs of various machine learning and artificial intelligence topic. You can find it on Nolders blogs. We do internal KT sessions, that is knowledge transfer session as company culture, and release them on YouTube so that other can also use them for their increment in knowledge. So there is a product, apart from sharing our knowledge about ML and AI, we are going to release one of our product called Magid pretty soon. It is a meeting intelligent assistant which can do a lot of wonders while attending meeting. It will give a video recording facility. Along with that, it will give the AI powered feature like automatic action generation, emotion analysis, facial detection, and many more. As you might have already imagined, if you have these powers while doing your meeting or doing any conversation with your colleague or client, you can compete with Sherlock Holmes or his power. After that, let's talk about KSAI a little bit. So KSAI is a machine learning library which contains various algorithms such as classification, regression, clustering, and many others. It is an attempt to build machine learning algorithms with the language Scala. The library Breeze, which is again built on Scala, is getting used for doing the mathematical functionalities. KSAI mainly used Scala's inbuilt case classes feature and some of the other cool features. It has also used Akka in some places and tried doing things in an asynchronous fashion. In order to start exploring the library, the test cases might be good start. So you can go to the KSAI Nolders GitHub repo and you will have an instruction there how to use it in your project. Right now, it might not be that easy to use the library with limited documentation and unclear API. However, the committers will update them in the near future. But now let's jump to our main topic for the day. So how machine learning is transforming medical treatment and diagnosis. So what is healthcare? Healthcare is an important industry which offers value-based care to the million of people, while at the same time becoming top revenue earner for many countries. Today, the healthcare industry in United States of America alone on a revenue of $1.668 trillion. the US also spends more on healthcare per capita as compared to the most other developed or developing nation. Quality, value, and outcome are the three buzzwords that always accompany healthcare and promise a lot. And today, healthcare specialists and stakeholders around the globe are looking for innovative way to deliver on this promise. Technology-enabled smart healthcare is no longer a flight of fancy. As internet connection medical devices are holding the health system as we know it together from falling apart under the population burden. Now how machine learning will change healthcare, or what is the role of machine learning in healthcare? So from playing a critical role in patient care, billing and medical record, today's technology is allowing healthcare specialists develop alternate staffing model. IP capitalization provides smart healthcare and reducing administrative and supply cost. Machine learning in healthcare is one such area which is seeing gradually acceptance in the healthcare industry. Google recently developed a machine learning algorithm to identify cancerous tumor in mammogram, and researchers in Stanford University are using deep learning to identify skin cancer. Machine learning is already lending a hand in diverse situations in healthcare. ML or machine learning is healthcare. In healthcare, helps to analyze thousands of different data points and suggest outcome. We will see it in our research also. I had done the same work which defined here, collecting the points and suggest outcome. It provides timely risk scores, precise resources allocation, and has many other applications. In this webinar, we will discuss some of the top applications of machine learning in healthcare and how they stand to change the way we visualize the healthcare industry in 2019 and beyond. So why machine learning or AI is important in healthcare? Let's took a minute and see some stats. So there are many ways AI and ML is important for healthcare sector to give better and affordable healthcare service. Hospital error is one of the leading cause of patient death. Such errors can be addressed and prevented by artificial intelligence. Nearly 440,000 Americans die each year due to medical errors, which can be easily prevented by AI or ML. In the healthcare industry, nearly 86% of the mistakes are preventable that can easily be resolved by using ML or AI. For the reason, in next 5 years, artificial intelligence health market will grow up by more than 10%. So let's move forward and see some of the medical and healthcare application of machine learning, how the current companies or organizations using machine learning in medical treatment and healthcare, and what are the applications of machine learning in healthcare. So the increasingly growing number of applications of machine learning in healthcare allow us to glimpse at a future where data and analysis and innovation work hand in hand to help countless patients without them even realizing it. Soon it will be a quite common to find ML-based application embedded with real-time patient data available from different healthcare systems in multiple countries, thereby increasing the efficiency of new treatment options which were unavailable before. So let's talk about some of the application of machine learning in healthcare. So let's see the first use case or application is identifying diseases and diagnosis. So one of the chief ML application in healthcare is the identification and diagnosis of diseases and ailment which are otherwise considered hard to diagnose before we implement machine learning in our applications. This can include anything from cancers which are tough to catch during the initial stages or before machine learning era to other genetic diseases. IBM Watson genomics is a prime example of how integrating cognitive computing with genome-based tumor sequencing can help in market a fast diagnosis. Burge, the biopharma giant, is leveraging AI to develop therapeutic diseases in areas such as oncology. PI Vitals predict its predicting response to depression treatment aims to develop a commercially feasible way to diagnose and provide treatment in routine clinical conditions. So this was all about identifying diseases and diagnosis. Let's move to the second use case or application. So a famous and very innovative use case of AI and ML in healthcare is drug discovery and manufacturing. So one of the primary clinical application of machine learning lies in early stage drug discovery process. This also includes R&D technologies such as next generation sequencing and precision medicine, which can help in finding alternative paths for therapy of multifactorial diseases. Currently, the machine learning techniques involve unsupervised learning, which can identify patterns in the data without providing any prediction. Project Hanover, developed by Microsoft, is using ML-based technology for multiple initiatives, including developing AI-based technology for cancer treatment and personalizing drug combination of AML, that is acute myeloid leukemic. So another use case is medical image diagnosis. So machine learning and deep learning are both responsible for the breakthrough technology called computer vision. This has found acceptance in the inner eye innovative developed by Microsoft, which work on image diagnostic tool for image analysis. As machine learning become more accessible and as they grew in their explanatory capacity, except to see more data resources from various medical imagery become a part of AI-driven diagnostic processes. Another one is smart health recorder, and really interesting thing to see. So maintaining up-to-date health record is an exhaustive process, and while technology has played its part in easing the data entry process, the truth is that even now, a majority of the processes take a lot of time to complete. The main role of machine learning is healthcare to ease processes to save time, effort, and money. Document classification method uses vector machines and ML-based OCR recognition techniques, a slowly gathering stream, and such as Google Cloud's Vision API and MATLAB's machine learning-based handwritten recognition technology. MIT is today at the cutting edge of developing the next generation of intelligence, smart health records, which will incorporate ML-based tools from the ground up to the help with diagnosis, clinical treatment suggestion, etc. So now see the another use case, that is machine learning based behavioral modification. So behavioral modification is an important part of preventing medicine, and ever since the proliferation of machine learning in healthcare, countless startups are cropping up in this field of cancer prevention and identification, patient treatment, etc. Somatix is a B2B and B2C based data analytic company, which has released an ML-based app to recognize gestures which we make in our daily lives, allowing us to understand our consciousness and behavior and make necessary changes in our daily routine or behavior. Another application is better radiotherapy. So one of the most sought after application of machine learning in healthcare is in this field of radiology. Medical image analysis has many discrete variables which can arise at any particular moment of time. There are many lessons, cancer, foci, etc., which cannot be simplified modeled using complex equations. since ML-based algorithm learn from the multitude of different samples available on hand, it become easier to diagnose. It become like easier to diagnose and find the variables which we earlier mentioned. One of the most popular uses of machine learning in medical image analysis is the classifying of objects, such as lesion into categories such as normal or abnormal, lesion or non-lesion, etc. So recently, Google's DeepMind, that is biggest deep learning organization in this world, so DeepMind Health is actively helping researchers in UCLH develop algorithm which can detect the difference between healthy and cancerous tissue and improve radiation treatment for the same. So another application is outbreak or we can say outbreak prediction. So AI-based technology and machine learning are today also being put to use in monitoring and predicting epidemics around the world. Today, scientists have access to the large amount of data collected from the satellites, real-time social media updates, or any website information you mentioned there or uploading on Google, on you make your own website and feed some data to your website, etc. Artificial neural networks help to collate this information and predict everything from malaria outbreaks to serve chronic infectious diseases. Predicting these outbreaks is especially helpful in third world countries as they lack in crucial medical infrastructure and educational system. A primary example of this is ProMedMail, an internet-based reporting platform which monitors involving diseases and emerging burns and provides outbreak report in real time. So these are some like use cases of machine learning in healthcare or medical treatment and diagnosis. So which are those top companies which are using these techniques and using machine learning to provide these type of use cases to the society? So let's talk about some of the companies which are already using these use cases and applications. So far we have seen AI and robotics in training, keeping the wellness of and patient, early detection of diseases and diagnosis process using machine learning, or any decision making process using AI or machine learning. So let's move to the top companies which are using these applications. So the first one is Quantum Health. So Quantum Health, using smart recording using machine learning and AI, the company's founding CEO Jason Michael O'Yurake recently spoke that healthcare's disruptive next generation at the CEO Healthcare Symposium in New York. So with the help of machine learning, Quantum Health developed software that aimed to reduce the cost of supportive EMR, or we can say electronic medical records systems, by optimizing and standardizing the way those systems are designed. The ultimate goal is to improve the care at a lower cost. Another one is CanCI. So CanSCI uses the predict illness, means they can predict the illness before it occurs or which type of illness this is. So CanSCI recently partnered with healthcare consulting firm T3K Health to focus on helping harness AI and machine learning for health records and workflow. So CanSCI uses machine learning to predict illness and treatment to help physicians and payers intervene earlier. Predict population health risk by identifying pattern and surfacing high risk makers and model diseases progression and more. Another company is Sciox Health. So Sciox Health, the company recently partnered with Chicago-based Northwestern Memorial Healthcare to being efficiency and transparency to Northwestern memorial release of information, that is ROI process. So PsyOps Health uses machine learning to enhance health information management and exchange of health information with the goal of modernizing workflow, facilitating access to clinical data, and improving the accuracy and flow of health information. So another company is Path AI. So Path AI is using machine learning for medical imaging and diagnostics. The company founded in 2017. In 2017, the company raised an additional of $11 million in a Series A funding round, which brought its total bank to $15 million. So Path AI's technology employs machine learning to help pathologists make quicker and more accurate diagnosis, as well as identifying patients that might benefit from new types of treatments and therapies. The another company is Pfizer, and this is really interesting. According to firebiotech.com, Pfizer expanding its collaboration with Chinese tech startup XTelPR to develop an artificial intelligence powered platform to the model small molecule drugs as part of its discovery and developing efforts. So how they are using machine learning is with the help of IBM's Watson AI technology. I hope you all like aware of this IBM Watson. So IBM's Watson, with the help of IBM Watson AI technology, Pfizer uses machine learning for immuno-oncology research and how the body's immune system can fight against the cancer. The project will combine quantum mechanics and machine learning to help predict the pharmaceutical properties of a broad range of molecular compounds. So the next one is, we all know about Microsoft. So Microsoft's project InnerEye employs machine learning to differentiate between tumors and healthy anatomy using 3D radiological images that assist medical experts in radiotherapy and surgical planning, among other things. So InnerEye is used in the United Kingdom to produce 3D imaging that pinpoints the precise location of tumors and enable more accurately targeted radiotherapy. Another organization is Precision Health AI. So Precision Health AI using machine learning to analyze oncology data, providing insights that allow oncologists and pharmaceuticals companies and payers and providers to practice precision medicine and health. It recently launched platform Eureka Health Oncology uses deep data from electronic medical records to train innovative AI solutions for the management, delivery and use of clinical data that integrates seamlessly into existing workflow. So according to the company CEO Bagem Hyde, this statement was made. Another one and my favorite is Beta Bionics, because it's matched to my research work which I had done recently. So Beta Bionics is developing a wearable bionic pancreas, it called the iLet, which manages blood sugar level around the clock in those with type 1 diabetics. The company was recently awarded by an ESBOR grant valued at up to $2 million by the NIH-affiliated National Institute of Diabetics and Digestive and Kidney Diseases, that is NIDDK. So we have till now seen some of the use cases of machine learning and AI in healthcare, and some top companies which are using machine learning and AI. So Now go to the interesting one and the major one for this webinar. That is my research paper. So my research paper was on predicting on diabetics patients hospital readmission rate. So and hospital readmission is considered when a patient is discharged from the hospital and get readmitted in the hospital within a certain period of time. Hospital readmission considered an effective measurement of service and care provided within the hospital. Emergency readmission to the hospital is frequently used as a measure of the quality of hospital because a high proportion of readmissions should be preventable if the preceding care is adequate. So what was the target and how we came through this idea? So the burden of diabetes among hospitalized patients, however, is substantial and growing and costly. As my father is also suffering from diabetes, so I know how much it is costly for a person to get in treatment for diabetes. So readmission contribute a significant proportion for this burden and of this burden. Reducing readmission rate of diabetic patients has a potential to greatly reduce healthcare cost while simultaneously providing or improving healthcare. The patients with high risk are more likely to get readmitted in the hospital. Hospital readmission is very costly for the patients who get readmitted in hospitals again and again and again. So government of United States has come up with a program, Hospital Readmission Reduction Program, under Section 3025, Patient Protection and Affordable, and Act in 2010. This act started in 2013, and the objective of this act was to reduction in readmission of patients by penalizing the hospital which has higher readmission rate, and to improve healthcare quality by improving services, medication, and also to make patients aware of the readmission and how they can avoid hospital readmission by taking effective measurement. So now let's go to the solution which I had made. So this is a solution notebook I had already prepared for you guys, because on the runtime it can take a lot of time to run, as you already know how much machine learning models or training can take the time. So here the target of this research paper was to find out what factors are the strongest predictors of hospital readmission in diabetic patients, and how well we can predict hospital readmission in the data set with limited feature. For now, these are the limited features which I am using, but our future work is to use many other features which will be provided by hospitals. So here I am importing pandas and NumPy, which is a Python library which we use for analyzing of our data, and Matplotlib for data visualization, and Seaborn also for data visualization. And let's proceed. So here I am importing my data set. So my data set consists of 50 features and about 117,000 of records. So if I check the, these are the like data types of my data set, and this is how our data is look like. Our encounter ID of the patient, encounter patient number, the race of any patient, gender, age, weight, and so on, and how much time he is spending in hospital. So after that, this is the last few rows of our data set. And first of all, we are doing data cleaning part, and I had recently write an article on data cleaning, and according to me, a data scientist or machine learning engineer spend its 80% of time in data cleaning rather than in model training or actually data analysis or machine learning part. So it is a very important step which we have to do with very care. So first of all, we are checking for missing value in our data. So there are these are the values, or we can say missing values in each of our attribute or our feature. So we know how much data is missing from the data set, and we can accordingly treat our data. So after describing our data set, we came to know about mean and standard deviation and what is the minimum value of our data set in each of the like attribute or column. So let's begin with the data pre-processing part. So first of all, we have previously seen that there are some missing values in our data set. So the weight variable is missing in over 98% of records. So owing to the poor interpretability of missing issues and little predictive generability to other patients, the best thing is to just drop it, because there is no use of using that 2% of record. It can affect our model training. And the payer code and medical specialty of treating physician also have 40 to 50 missing values. So we can also drop these columns, but there are other ways to deal with such missing values. So here we are dropping weight, payer code and medical specialty. So primary or diag 1, secondary diag 2 and additional diag 3 diagnosis, these are the type of diagnosis. So they will have some few missing values. Technically, if all there are missing, that's a bad data. So we only drop those records where all three diagnosing missings or diagnoses are missing. So gender has only three missing or invalid values, so we decide to drop these records. Also, one more cleaning step that depends on understanding the data. If you are solving any problem you might have or should have, and domain knowledge, whether in healthcare or finance or any other agriculture, so you must have a domain knowledge. So according to that domain knowledge, or depend on the understanding, some common sense, since we are trying to predict readmissions, those patients who died during the hospital readmission have zero probability of readmission. So we should remove those records, which is discharge disposition is equal to 11. So here we had dropped those columns or rows which have all the three diagnoses as a null value. And after that, we have dropped some other features which have more missing values or invalid IDs. So we also noticed that for two variables, drug named cytogliptin and examide, all records have same value. So essentially, these cannot provide any interpretive or discriminatory information for predicting readmission, because it can like confuse your model while training what output should it give. So we should drop these values too. So here we have dropped these values. So after that, we again check for the missing values, and here it is, no missing value in our data set. So now our data set is prepared for data analysis. So now if we can see the head of our data set, it's totally different from the previous one. The previous one which we had has some of these missing values in it, and some of the false values or invalid values also. So you can simply see the change in our data set now, and also our data set is reduced because we have dropped so much of like entries or records. So after that, we have to do some feature engineering, that is to provides or combining many features into one, or identify the most relatable features in our data set which can be used to predict readmission rate or readmission value. So this is highly subjective. The partially depend on knowledge of healthcare services and make sense of the potential relationship between features. So there is a feature service utilization. The data contain variable for number of inpatients, admissions, emergency room visits, and outpatient visits for a given patient in the previous 1 year. So here what we are doing is containing our three attributes or three features, that is number of outpatients, number of emergencies, and number of inpatients, and we are combining it to make one feature, that is service utilization. How much service and patient is using or utilize while in the hospital. So number of medicines changes also played an important feature. We can identify it with our domain knowledge. So the dataset contains 23 features for 23 drugs or combos of drugs, which indicate for each of these. So the keys are these are the drug types. We have made a combination of these 23 types of drug, and we have counted the numbers after that. So these are the numbers. After that, we re-encode admission type and discharge type and admission source into fear categories, because we have to make a model on a predictive level or category level, and we have to categorize our entries. After that, we make a training model, so we have to change our data into category type. So these are some steps I had made, to change the keys in one or in between one of zero, because our machine understand these language easily and fastly, and we always want our product or service to be fast. So we are changing these things into one and zero, in the term of one and zero, so it can do a better categorize or classify things. Also, we are visualize or checking the age values. So here from 70 to 80, we have 24,000 of patients, and 60 to 70, 21,000. And it makes sense, because we all know that at these ages, generally people have diabetes. So this is a good data we have to predict. So here we have to drop some duplicate values in patient number, because it might be possible that same patient is coming again and again, and we are keeping the first record of the same patient. So the number of medication used is the another possibly related factor, could be the total number of medications used by the patient. So here this is our data set now, and these are some values. So here let's see our main the targeted variable or targeted column which we have to predict. Either a patient is coming within a 30 days of time or not. So here we have the data set. So this is the count values for our target variable. So there are 34,000 peoples who are coming after 30 days, and there are 11,066 there which are coming before 30 days. So here we are creating some additional columns for our diagnosis type. So here if we can see now, our age is object type, and all other variables are of object type, which previously are of the other type. So now we are also converting some of our useful features into 0 and 1 So here we have change our like some of the variables into categorical values, and we get here we are getting the list of only numerical features. So the numerical features are number of outpatient, number of lab procedure, or number of diagnosis and patient gone through, and number of inpatient or service utilization, means number of service and patient is utilized. So as we know that our data was previously imbalanced and skewed, means it is going into one way. So there is a problem of skewness and ketosis. So using log transformation, we can remove these type of problems, like taking the log of our values, and it will reduce the data set into a smaller value or the near value to 0 and 1. So here we are doing this thing. Don't be afraid of these long codes. If you want to have an access on this like data sheet or the project sheet, you can simply mail to the Noldus or the mail you got for this webinar, or we will send an like feedback form and feedback mail. So you can write here, right there, that you want an like either an slides or this project sheet or the research paper which is published on this ACM digital library. So you can also get an access on simply logged in ACM digital library and search for the title prediction on diabetes patients hospital readmission rate. It is like recently published on this digital library, and I had done this research with my few fellows and my two mentors. So coming back to the problem, here we had like done log transformation for the columns we needed, and after that we have an precise and good data, we can say, and good data for the prediction. So here are some feature scaling. We are scaling our values from larger to smaller so that our model can easily predict the outcome, and after that we are seeing the correlation between our features, so we can easily learn how much related and feature is to the nearer feature or the other features. So after that we had gone through some of the procedures, some of the analytic part, and the modeling part of our pre-processing data, and we had make an a feature set. So these are the features we came through after the pre-processing and visualization part, which can help our model to predict a good outcome. So age, time in hospital, number of procedures, number of medications, and so on. These are some features which can affect our outcome of readmission. So we have used first logistic regression and simple machine learning algorithm. So with the starting assumption that the impact of factors and their interaction can be modeled as log likelihood of outcome, logistic regression can help us understanding the relative impact and statistical significance of each factor on a probability of readmission. We handled missing values by either removing the column or following the pre-processing step as described in our previous like previous things. So now we let's see the values of our readmission or target variable. So there are these are the two things, like 0 and 1. 0 is like a patient is not readmitted in 30 days, and the 1 is the patient readmitted within 30 days. So zero, we have categorized it into 0 and 1 from no and yes. So here are the value: 54,000 for the negative and 5,000 for the positive. So here we have used scikit-learn for our model selection, and splitting our model into test and train. So whoever from you guys are from machine learning background, you know why we are separating our data set into training and test. And other developers too, you can relate it with your implementation and unit test cases, so that you can know either your code or your implementation is working fine. Actually, it's a cross validation process you can use. So after we train our model with logistic regression algorithm, we have an accuracy of nearly 91%, but the precision was not there and recall is not there. Since our target variable is having class imbalance problem, we will use SNOT technique to resolve it. So SNOT is an important technique whenever you deal with the data imbalancing, and it's actually a general, or we can say common, problem for every data set. So every time you will use a categorical data set, surely there will be a data imbalancing thing with your data set. So you can simply import the library imblearn and use the oversampling part in there and import SNOT. So SMOT is the technique to remove the data imbalancing, and it can actually reshape your data into a way it is then balanced, and your training model will be more precise. So here we are use SNOP, and after SNOP, SMOT. So when we predict our output with logistic regression, it's actually giving us a little bit of low accuracy, and that is 87% or a 61% with the test data. So the precision was also low and the recall is also low. So by iteratively and hierarchical observing the level of certainty of predicting whether someone would be readmitted or not, we find the relative importance of different factor using a human-like decision making strategy in establishing this determine. So the machine learning background people, you know how decision tree works. It works on the basis of if and else. Like if the condition is this, you can go to the down node, or the decision is this, or the factor is this, value is this. We have to go to the right node or left node. Or you can go through the different blocks on decision tree, and hope you will find it interesting. So after we used SMOT and train our decision tree classifier, we get an accuracy of nearly 92%, precision and recall of 93 and 90%, and it's really good for our predicting model or our research. So from this we know approach should be. Our approach should be tree based. So if we in decision tree, we can also create the list of topmost features which are important or which were the important at the training time of our decision tree. So here the features are, that is time in hospital, number of diagnosis, number of medicines, number of procedures, and the age, gender, and insulin level of a patient. So by considering more than one decision tree and doing a majority voting, random forest help in being more robust predictive representations than trees as in our previous case. For both decision tree and random forest, we remove the interaction term from the feature set since there are already accounted for in tree-based model. So after that, we import the same scikit-learn assemble library. Actually, these are the assemble library which uses number of input and output, and based on previous output, we can correct the next procedure or next step. So that is random forest is all about. So after training up a random forest, we make some prediction, and we found that this model having accuracy of about 94%, precision of a very high precision of 99%, and recall and AUC is also good. So we can consider random forest for our research of or for our solution. After that, boosting techniques are getting more attention and more consideration in nowadays, because they are using some like functions on improving itself step by step. So ADA boost is one of the few techniques in boosting, and we also use ADA boost after SMOT. So when we perform SMOT and like importing sklearn assemble and import ADA boost classifier, we trained our ADA boost model and predict from ADA boost model, so it gives an accuracy of 71%. So after that, we have performed training and prediction on many many of our ML algorithms, and now we have to see which model is giving us higher accuracy so that we can use that model in our deployment or production part, or deploy it anywhere where our hospital services are running, so that doctors or doctor or physicians can make easy decisions by simply filling in form and giving the variables and see the target variables. So after that, we use matplotlib for a better visualization and consider which model will be the best one for our solution. So as we can see, the red bar is for accuracy, blue is for precision, green is for recall, and the yellow one is for AUC. So simply we can see that random forest and our decision tree making a big impact, or the models with higher accuracy and precision recall than AUC. So you can, from here we can also know that the problem should be solved with a tree-based approach. So from here we can decide that we should use our random forest learning algorithm, because it is giving us the higher accuracy and higher precision. So this was a smaller part of our research. Actually, it's a software we had made and I had made with my colleagues. So it was a small demonstration of our project, or we can say a simply ML side of that software. So this was all about my research. So after that, the conclusion of this research was we pre-process data using various techniques like feature encoding, feature scaling, and other outlier treating. We had also treated the outliers which are not important for our prediction part by doing data visualization and data analytics, or analyzes our data from our data set, and we add some new features to our data set. We handle the class imbalance problem using synthetic minority oversampling technique. Then we applied machine learning model like logistic regression, decision tree, random forest, ADA boost, and XGBoost for prediction, and achieve highest accuracy of 94% using random forest. Then we implement decision tree and random forest to detect top significant features which contribute most to our readmission of patients. So these features are time in hospital, discharge and disposal ID, number of diagnoses, number of medicines, and the number of procedures. So there is also a future work for this research, and that is we had 90% 98 or 90% of missing values in our data set. So might be those features can also contribute to the prediction, or it may be possible that those were the important values, but we don't have the data of those features. So the future work is to create a data set with less null values and with the large data of about near lakhs or millions, so we can predict accurately, and we can also increase performance of our model by tuning hypermeters of the models. So in actual research process, we had tuned our model by changing its parameters and everything. So you can also do this cool things by just accessing this project sheet from us. So you can also request us to send it to you. Just write on the email, same email, we will send you for the feedback. So this is all about my webinar. If you have any questions, send it to the same email link. And if you want to have a recording of this webinar, please request to the same email. Thank you and have a nice day.